So we are on our way into Home Hardware. I need to pick up the electrical supplies for the garden shed. So it's a bit of a road trip today. So we've got some odds and ends to pick up, a couple of things for the yard. And it's a lovely day, so should be a very nice drive. Okay, here we are. It doesn't seem too busy here. Should be pretty easy. I do have a fair bit of stuff to pick up. All right, let's go see what we can find. Well, that went pretty good. I got pretty much, I think, everything I need, including some stain. So I've got all the electrical parts, and we'll, I think, take a break, go get some lunch, and then head home. Well, there we go. It's lunch break. We did pretty good. The only thing left to do is stop at the corn stand on the way home. They're pretty well organized at the drive-thru. It was really pretty easy. Went through a lot quicker than I thought it would. So I went with the old traditional Big Mac and fries. A nice little treat. And then we'll get back to work. It is gorgeous here. I'm in the last dual park right now. I'll give you a look around. It's a pretty spot. So let's eat. So we're back out in the shop today. I'm gonna see if I can get a little bit of work done on the garden shed. I'm gonna prep for wiring. My initial plan was to get the staining done first because of the holes I have to cut in the walls for plugs and switches and stuff like that. Just be easier to have the staining done and then cut the holes in afterwards. A little less things to stain around. But the weather isn't going to allow for that because we have the threat of rain off and on for the next 3 days, which is a real pain in the butt. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the wiring job. So I got a few pieces to cut to hold fixtures inside the shop. And I have the door stops to install to hold the doors open. And it is another blistering hot day today. The heat wave has returned. We've got a little over 35 degrees in the shop here right now. And who knows with the humidity factor, because it practically feels wet out there. The air is so humid. But we'll do what we can do and continue on. We're just gonna get a bit wet in the process. So let's get rolling. Just getting started out here. Already had a power failure because of the thunderstorms moving into the area. I've got an extension cord run out, and I've got my big fan going, but it is blistering hot inside this thing. So I've got a few of my electrical boxes hung so far, and I've got to start cutting a vent for the back here so that I do get some flow through ventilation. But, oh my goodness, it is hot. Okay, let's get back to work. Really threatening out here. Holy mackerel. There's a lot of rumbling going on. Well, I thought just for the fun of it, I'm gonna sit here in the garden shed and watch this thing roll through and see what it does. There's quite a black cloud coming right over the house. I'm not sure you guys can hear all that thunder, but it sure is rocking and rolling up there. So I've got all the wire run now. So there's my source of supply coming in through the bottom sole plate 2x4 there. And that will go up and connect into that hex box. The red cable, which is, I just use it simply because it's left over from another job. But the red cable is the power supply that goes up to the first plug, then goes across the ceiling to the second plug. That's the plug for my heating system for the lawn tractor for the winter. And in and over and out to this switch. So there's the location of the switch just outside the door. And that switch will turn on the three lights that I have. So I've got one over top of the door right there. So the wires are coming through for that there. And as you can see, it switches over to white. That spot is for the first of the indoor lights. The white cable runs back across over to the light fixture at the far end, so there is light number two. And the other thing I've got going on is I've got the white cable here coming out of the hex box. That's going to go up and across and out, and that is to an outdoor plug that I've got outside there. I need something on the back to power my Bud Light. So next step is to start putting all the plugs and lights and whatnot in, get those all wired into place. Okay, we got all the wiring in place. Plugs and lights are all wired up. I just tied us back into the power supply line. So let's flip the switch and see what happens. Okay, here we go. Yes. We have power. Everything's working. All right. Now we have to clean up from this and head into Home Hardware, probably Home Depot, because I need eave troughs and all the material for the shelving that's going up against this wall. So I'm going to clean all this out, get all these tools put away, and get ready for the next step. Well, there's the first coat of floor paint on. I'll try to get one more on later on today. Well, while I'm waiting for the garden shed floor to dry so I can put down one more coat of paint, I've got my little platform here that I built quite some time ago to put this little fireplace onto that we got from Costco. It was quite inexpensive, and I don't know how long it'll last, but it looked pretty neat. Can actually cook in it, have a small fire in it, and it's got the screen on it to keep the embers from floating around and that kind of thing, which is good. So I'll see if I can make it work. Thank you. Well, that's it for the floor on the garden shed. That's about 5 coats of this gray paint on it. I put so much on because this floor is going to take a lot of abuse, especially in the winter time, considering that the lawn tractor with the snowblower on it's going to park in here. So it's going to get wet and messy. So we need to protect it as much as possible. So this should help. So the next step in this is to build the shelves and of course to stain the outside. But I think that's going to be it for today's video. It's time to go find a cold beer and try to get out of this bloody sun. So, thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you out on the trail next time.